Orange Wolfie. Hello, friend. Being in the present moment. I have attention to the walls around me, to the cats, to the heater. This state of mind keeps me out of the rushing rivers of thought. Or another way to put it, this attentive state of mind. Holds back the rushing river of thought. Holds back the rushing river of root chakra pain. It holds back the rushing river of ego control. It is 8:46 p.m. Saturday. And I can feel myself here and there start to slip into the river of rushing thoughts. But because of my attention to the present moment, purposely, slipping away, lost in thought, is dramatically diminished. To the point that I have not slipped into thought at all. During this whole 8 minutes, 14 minutes of video. I feel some root chakra pain wanting to lightly develop right now as I struggle for words to say. Which tells me that I'm speaking too much. I have my baby Schwoof kitty on my lap. This is my lead male cat, Judah Jr. And he is very comfortable. I heard the neighbor back out of his driveway and drive down the rock gravel road. I am purposely remaining in this present moment. This keeps me out of the rushing river of thoughts, which usually is full of thoughts that want to do this and want to do that, want to think this and want to think that. Pepper the cat just walked in the room. Pepper. He's looking at me. Now he looked away. Pepper. Pepper the cat. Now he's thinking about jumping on the bed. My mother and I discussed coercion. Hi, Pepper the cat. We discussed the starer. Getting locked in staring at another person. When we get locked in staring at another person, this diminishes our capability of staying in the present moment, observing our surroundings. There's a difference between observing our surroundings and observing our thoughts and getting locked in thought. Every time I look around, I can sense that it's an opportunity for the mind to slip away into the rushing river of thought. But I'm purposely catching myself. Purposely. Keeping my attention on the walls, in the room, on the guitars, on the couch, the hats hanging on the wall, the various papers pinned up on the wall, the coat hanging on the wall. Looking at the wall and describing the atmosphere in generalities, as opposed to getting lost in the rushing rivers of descriptive details. And if, as I said that phrase, descriptive details, I felt myself dip down in attention toward the rushing river of thoughts for a fraction of a second, but I caught myself. As I'm remaining attentive in this present moment, I sense in the very background certain thoughts that are lightly passing by. But it's a comfortable lightness. It's not a rapids of rushing thoughts attached to fear. Worry, anxiety. Thoughts are passing by in the very distant background. thoughts of what shall I eat? But when I fully give my attention to my surroundings in this present moment, there is no desire to eat. There is no desire to do anything. The only desire there is to rest. To love myself. To wait and trust as I scratch underneath the chin of Judah Jr. slowly and lovingly in a way that he's enjoying it. He has a little bit of tail's wish. One of my thoughts wants me to reach over to the camera and tilt it down so that we can see Junior. But my attention desires stillness and rest. One of my subscriptions is from a YouTuber called Top Dog, and he put up 4 videos for the first time in many months. I interpretate this as manufactured signs of Mother Nature supporting my position as top dog on the earth. As I remain in this present moment, there are no drifting away into the thoughts of fear, worry, doubt, and unbelief. My root chakra is feeling compressed from sitting here, though. If I were to sit up slowly, it's been sunny today. I put a pillow behind my lower back to support it. I felt myself slip into thought a little bit there for past two seconds, but I quickly brought myself out of it. Alright, that will be it for this video. And I will remain in the present moment after I stop the video.